Jose Pedro Castillo, born in 1902 and passed away in 1985, was a prominent Uruguayan painter, engraver, and sculptor, known for his significant contributions to the development of modern art in Uruguay. Born on July 23, 1902, in Montevideo, Uruguay, Castillo's artistic journey unfolded against the backdrop of a change in cultural landscape in Latin America during the 20th century. He began his formal art education at the Círculo de Bellas Artes in Montevideo, where he studied under the guidance of renowned Uruguayan artists such as Vicente Puig and Guillermo Laborde. During the early years of his career, he explored various artistic styles, including figurative and landscape painting. He was influenced by European modernism, particularly the avant-garde movements that emerged in the early 20th century. In the 1930s, he played a key role in the development of the constructivist movement in his country. He, along with other artists such as Joaquin Torres Garcia, and formed the Asociación de Arte Constructivo in 1935. This movement aimed to promote geometric abstraction and the use of primary colors, emphasizing a universal language in art. Castillo's artwork would, during this period, reflect a shift towards geometric shapes and a departure from traditional art forms. Throughout his career, he exhibited his works in numerous solo and group exhibitions in Uruguay and internationally. His art evolved over time, incorporating elements of abstraction and symbolism. He experimented with various mediums, including painting, engraving, and sculpture. His artistic versatility allowed him to engage with different forms of expression, contributing to the richness of his body of work. Castillo's impact extended beyond his artistic endeavors. He was actively involved in a cultural and educational initiatives promoting modern art in Uruguay. He participated in the creation of important institutions such as the Taller Torres Garcia, which played a crucial role in shaping the artistic scene in his home country. His works are included in prestigious collections and museums worldwide, cementing his legacy as a pivotal figure in the history of Uruguayan art. Jose Pedro Castillo passed away on March 2nd, 1985, leaving behind a lasting legacy as a trailblazer in the development of modern art and abstract art in Uruguay. His contributions continue to be celebrated, and his influence is subsequent on generations of artists is undeniable. Jose Pedro Castillo's artwork is characterized by its evolution through various artistic movements and styles, reflecting his versatility and engagement with broader context of the 20th century art. Here is an analysis of his work, highlighting key aspects of his artistic journey. During the early period and his figurative art of his career, Castillo provided figurative paintings and landscapes influenced by traditional artistic styles. His early works demonstrated a mastery of technique and a keen observation of the surrounding environment. through his relation with constructivism and geometric abstraction, a significant turning point in Kosciuszko's career occurred when he became associated with these movements in the 1930s. Inspired by European avant-garde movements, he embraced geometric abstraction, incorporating precise lines, geometric shapes, and primary colors into his compositions. The constructivist period reflects a commitment to universal language in art, emphasizing order, structure, and a departure from representational forms. He eventually integrated an evolution towards abstraction as his career progressed. His work evolved towards greater abstraction. He moved beyond strict adherence to constructivism, allowing for more freedom and expression in his compositions. His abstract works often feature a harmonious balance of color, form, and space, showcasing a mature understanding of the interplay between elements. During his multimedia exploration, Kosciuszko's artistic exploration extended beyond painting. He engaged with engraving and sculpture, showcasing his versatility and willingness to experiment with different mediums. This multimedia approach allowed him to explore diverse textures, forms, and techniques, contributing to the richness and diversity of his artistic output. In summary, José Pedro Kosciuszko's art is a dynamic and evolving journey through various styles and movements. From early figurative works to the geometric abstraction of the constructivist period and later his explorations in abstraction and symbolism. Kosciuszko's legacy lies not only in individual pieces, but his contribution to the broader narrative of Uruguayan modern art. Kosciuszko played a pivotal role in the development of modern art in Uruguay. His involvement in the constructionist movement and the establishment of culture institutions left an indelible mark on the country's artistic landscape. His influence, of course, extends beyond his own work, shaping the direction of art in Uruguay and contributing to a broader cultural shift towards modernism. José Pedro Kosciuszko's artwork has been exhibited in various solo and group exhibitions, both in Uruguay and internationally. Here is some of the notable institutions and locations where his work has been displayed. In his own country of Uruguay, his works has been featured in the National Museum of Visual Arts and the Torres Garcia Museum, for example. The National Museum of Visual Arts is in Montevideo and has likely hosted numerous exhibitions featuring his works. It serves as a significant institution for promotion and preservation of Uruguayan visual arts. As for the Torres Garcia Museum, also located in Montevideo, given Kosciuszko's association with the constructivist movement and his involvement in the Taller Torres Garcia, his work has been exhibited in this museum as well, which is dedicated to the influential Uruguayan artist Joaquín Torres Garcia. Of course, his work has also been featured in many international exhibitions, particularly in Latin America and European galleries, where these museums have featured many of his works throughout many different exhibitions, including in biennials and art fairs. many private collections as well have his work and may lend out some of the individual items to many other museums or galleries to feature as part of their exhibitions. Of course, many art institutions and cultural centers around the world have also included his works in either solo exhibitions about the artist or as a part of their other exhibitions featured on other topics. His works have also been featured in retrospective and commemorative exhibitions, either about his particular life and life work or to celebrate Latino artists from around the world. While specific exhibitions details may vary, research and exhibitions, catalogs, museums, and archives, as well as retrospectives dedicated to the Uruguayan art and modernism can provide a more comprehensive information about where exactly José Pedro Costa y Lilio's work has been exhibited.